Hello everyone, welcome you all in another lecture of structural analysis. We are looking into the strain energy method, and this is the third topic which we are covering in this unit. Okay, so before going into this detail, I am posting the link of the previous video. Just go through it and get the clear idea about the strain energy, and then this will get you very clear. Okay, so the numerical is given as A, B, C, D frame having length of AB member, BC member and CD member are 4 meter, and AB carries, that is this column carries the UDL of 2 kN per meter over the span of this 4 meter, where EI is the constant. So what we have to determine? We have to determine the value of H. So now in the earlier cases the load was symmetry, so due to which the horizontal forces which we have drawn in the direction towards the frame. But in this case, the horizontal force or the horizontal thrust will be in the opposite direction of the given loading condition. So this 2 kN per meter is in the direction of horizontal in x direction, positive. So the HA and HD will be in the opposite direction of this. Okay. So suppose this HA is nothing but this H. So this HD will be 8 minus H. This HD will be 8 minus H. How this come? If this is H, so the remaining distance will be 2 into 4, that is 8 kN minus H. So the sum of this H, both value HA plus HD must be equal to this load. Okay, so 2 into 4, that is 8 kN we are writing over here. Okay, so very first step is to calculate the reaction. So reaction we have drawn VD and VA. At this stage we don't know the direction of reaction, so we will calculate, we will consider VD as in the vertical direction, and we will come out with the RD value and RA value. Okay, so moment about A, we will consider the section at A. Moment about A is equals to 0. So C, there are two loading conditions which is acting about this A. First one is VD, so rotation of VD is in anti-clockwise direction, and this distance is 4 meter. So this minus 4 into RD plus this. Now we will talk about this UDL. So the rotation of UDL is in clockwise direction about A. So this will be equal to 2 into 4, that is 8 kN, and this will be at exactly at the center. So the distance is 2. So we can write this as 2 into 4 square by 2. So if you calculate this, we will get the value of RD is equals to 4 kN. Now to calculate RA, we will apply another equilibrium condition, that is summation FY equals to 0. So total RA plus RD, that is nothing but the VA and VD, is equals to 0, because there is no vertical loading opposite to this reaction. So reaction RA we will get minus 4 kN. Okay, and RD is 4 kN. So for this, RD is positive 4 kN, so we are drawing this in positive direction. This is 4 kN, and if RA is minus 4, so this is in downward direction. Okay, so this we have to consider while calculating the moment about any section. So RA is in the downward direction. Now we know the strain energy equation, that is sum of the integration of moment into partial derivative of moment with respect to H, dx is equals to 0. Now to determine this moment and del m by del h for all the individual members, we have to draw the table like this. So first one is the member, then origin, then limit, then m, then del m by del h. One another column should be added here if the EI is not constant. If the value of EI is differing all the members, then one additional column we will add here, EI, and separate value of EI will calculate for all the individual member, and that will be considered in calculation of moment. Okay, now we will talk on the section AB, that is member AB. The origin of AB member is A, limit is 0 to 4, we have to look into the length of that particular member, so 0 to 4. And now moment we will calculate. So how we will calculate the moment? First we will mark a section in AB span having the length x from A. See what load are rotating about this section. So this VA is not rotating about this section because this is passing through the axis. One load is there, that is horizontal thrust. So the rotation of this in the anti-clockwise direction, this rotation in clockwise direction, so this will be plus, so distance is x, so this will be plus h into x, so this plus h into x. Then when another load is there, UDL, so UDL is rotating in anti-clockwise direction at a distance of x, so this will be 2 into x, that will be applied at the center of this x, so the remaining distance will be x by 2. So we can write this as 2x square by 2. So this we have write 2x square by 2. If this we will cut this 2 with this 2, so the remaining value will be hx minus x square. If you derive this with h, then only x will be there. Okay, now another member is BC, origin is B, limit is 0 to 4. Now we are talking about this BC member, limit is 0 to 4. Now we will make a section from B, the distance is x. This is section xx. Okay, now see what type of loading are acting at this point. First one is this VA. So VA is acting in anti-clockwise direction, having the value of 4. So this is minus 4 into this x distance, minus 4 into x, plus now this h is acting, so this is acting in clockwise direction at the distance of 4 meters, so plus 4h, and then this load is acting 2 into 4 square by 2. So 2 into 4 square by 2, we are getting the value minus 16, which is acting in anti-clockwise direction, so minus 16. So the dLm by dL h value is 4. Okay, now the last portion DC, we will consider this portion from D. We will mark section xx up at the distance of x from D. See what type of loading is acting at this point. So this is only the load which is acting 8 minus h, and we can see the rotation which is clockwise. So section at the right side of the section, we are taking the moment if the moment is clockwise, we are taking is negative. So this is minus 8 minus h, 8 minus h into this x distance. Okay, if you calculate this bracket, so this will be hx minus 8x. Okay, and del m by del h value is x. Now we know the value of moment, we know the value of del m by del h. So without wasting time, we can directly put that m and del m by del h value into this equation and sum up for all the members. So we will write for first member AB, limit is 0 to 4, moment is hx minus x square into x del m by del h value into dx, plus another member is BC, having the moment minus 4x plus 4h minus 16 into 4 divided into dx, plus third member is minus 8x plus hx into x dx is equals to 0. If we elaborate these brackets, so we will get the value hx square, this x into x, this will be hx square minus x cube dx plus 0 to 4 minus 16x plus 16h minus 64 into dx, then hx square minus 8x square into dx is equals to 0. If you integrate this, you will get the power of x square increased by 1, and it is divided with the power of the same. So hx cube divided by 3 minus x raised to the power 4 divided by 4, 0 to 4, plus minus 16x square divided by 2 plus 16hx minus 64x, limit 0 to 4, then hx cube divided by 3 minus 8x cube divided by 3. Now for all this bracket, if you put the value of x as 4 and if you calculate by in the calculator, you will get the horizontal thrust as h is equals to 5.8 kN. So similar to the previous numerical, you can determine also the bending moment. Okay, so you can go through that numerical and how to calculate the bending moment, you can see from there, and you can draw the bending moment diagram for this numerical as well. Okay, so till then, thank you very much.